Hi, my name is Carlos and I'm with BittWare. BittWare as a company has a lot of boards with lots of I.O. When looking for a server solution, there's many options out there. It's difficult, actually, probably is very difficult to find a server that's going to be able to utilize these interfaces and draw them out to the front. In this case, LDA Tech has actually come up with a pretty unique solution with their LDA E4 box. In this instance, the XUPP3R board has I.O. out through the QSFP connector. You've got I.O. on your PCIe connector, and some more I.O. on the SCP out to the front. To get into more of the details, I have Sergey here from LDA Tech who can do that.
We created an enclosure specifically made for FPGA boards, from low profile to full size and height, up to double slot width. The device size is 1U, very short depth, is just 12 inches. It has 16 25 gigabits compatible ports and up to 32 10 gig compatible ports. So first we insert the QSFP active cables. So it's a very simple task, just insert the QSFP plugs. The second step is attaching SCP cable and the USB cable for management. So the very final stage, first we insert the FPGA board in the PCI Express connector, QSFP active cables, and the last part is SCP. Like this. A lot of applications from networking point of view can be implemented. Software-defined network switch, as well as security devices like VPN concentrators, router, firewall, intrusion detectors. We have some advanced functionality like cross-point switch fabrics sitting directly on our board. So for example, if some intrusion detection software is implemented here, the data that can go from port one exit from another port without even entering the FPGA. At the same time, same data can be copied to FPGA for further processing. So even if FPGA is not loaded at all, data flow won't be interrupted. So we have ComExpress Type 10 module here with Intel x86-64 CPU. We also support ComExpress Type 6 with better and more powerful CPUs like Intel Xeon D. For here, in this particular example, we have Intel Atom CPU, and it's connected to FPGA board through PCI Express X1 or USB.
As Sergey mentioned, with the USB interface to their module, you can use the BittWare toolkit, which allows you to do some functionality such as program the FPGA directly over USB. You can load the flash over the USB interface. In addition, we have our board management controller, which monitors power, temperature. You can reprogram clocks on the board. And it's nice because this is all done internally to the system. You don't have to come in and connect any external cables. In addition, with this XUPP3R board, there is a JTAG interface over the USB. So if you wanted to access JTAG, you could as well. And that's all, you know, it's all done already. The USB is connected and there's no hassle in running any wires to the system.
The Vivado Lab tools are pre-installed here already. The remote connectivity is available. So for example, in case of regular 1U server, it's a big issue to reprogram the FPGA on the fly because you have to reboot the machine, you have to wait until operating system starts, it checks memory, it could take up to 5 minutes to reload the FPGA image because everything has to be rebooted and done again. With this box, the FPGA board is programmed on the fly. And we have all the hot plug functionality here, and we allow to freeze the state of the driver and remember the configuration, last known good configuration of FPGA. So once FPGA is programmed, operating system will recognize it again and reprogram the register's PCI Express state, like its I/O memory, latency parameters and commands, so it will continue where it left off. Also, we support Windows operating system, which is really, really rare for FPGA development on boxes like this. So if some applications require Windows, customer is welcome to do it. So one of the features that we like most is ability to turn off the PCI Express power without touching the rest of the system. So the PCI Express power domain is completely decoupled from the system itself. Also, in addition to the ability to turn off and on the PCI Express power, we have precision power monitor of the FPGA board itself. We know how much power it draws, and we allow customers to program some thresholds. So for example, and connect them to the system fans. So we don't need to monitor the temperature of the FPGA. We'll allow customer to program it by on. For example, if FPGA draws 25 watts, the fan can be programmed to spin at 40%. When it gets higher to 50 watts, so we have 5 pre-compiled stages that customer can program. We have redundant power supplies here, and they are load shared, so we can actually program amount of power that drawn from each power supply. Everything is done on our base board. So for example, the usual application, the both power supplies are working in sync, so we divide the power drawn from them, but in some cases one power source is main, another is coming from backup, so we can program that in our device. So let's say 90% of the power is drawn from the main power supply and 10% is drawn from the second one. And once the power is cut, so it will completely move to the second one as a backup source. The startup time of this device is about 1 second. So once power is up, FPGA image is loaded, the device, the network ports will come up and start working. So all the configuration is stored directly on our baseboard. It's practically impossible to get such functionality from the regular server. So also the out-of-band management port here, it's a separate Linux machine. It's very small device that is living its completely independent. So we use this to allow like firmware upgrades, command line interface, like our GUI interface with the monitoring, port monitoring is connecting to here as well. So like to connect to this device externally, we have normal micro USB serial port. We have like display port to connect to the Linux ComExpress module. We have out of band management port, 2 USB ports and another Ethernet port, which is connected to Linux as well. Another very important feature of this device is precision clock source that we have here. And it's 100 megahertz oven-controlled crystal oscillator with accuracy of 10 parts per billion. It's a very accurate clock, and we have clock multiplexer on the device that allows to serve this clock as a PCI Express reference clock. So we don't need any special PCI clock source like SMA connector or whatever to feed that clock to the FPGA board. So the depth of this device is chosen to be 12 inches. It allows to install 2 of those in one U rack back to back, so effectively multiplying number of FPGA boards per one U space.
So I'd like to thank Sergey from LDA Tech for coming in and demonstrating the EVOR box, giving a lot more information and details on what it can do. I think it's a unique solution for being able to house a board like ours in it and pull out all these I/O ports. If you have any more questions or need any more information, you can visit us at bitware.com. Thanks for watching.